Welcome to the Spiro Connect with i3 integration training video from NewMed Healthcare. Before starting the test procedure, be sure the Spiro Connect wireless receiver is connected to a USB port on the PC. Ensure that you have the correct patient open within the clinical system. Click the i3 icon on your taskbar or desktop to start the integration software. Clicking the Start button will take you to the product selection screen. Click the spirometry icon. i3 will now connect to the clinical system and pull through the active patient's details. If the patient's height and weight have previously been recorded in the clinical system, these will also be shown, along with the date the measurements were last taken. If the values are out of date or not shown, these should be updated now. The ethnicity and smoking status should also be checked and updated if necessary. Once all the details are correct, confirm by clicking Yes. The patient details will be passed to the Spiro Connect software. If any mandatory information is missing, you will be prompted to complete the missing details. If the patient already exists in the Spiro Connect database and any of the details differ from those stored, you will see a window asking you to confirm the details should be updated. You must answer yes to proceed with the examination. Answering no will abort the test. You will only see this window if the patient details held in the spirometry database differ from those passed from the clinical system. As the spirometry software starts, you will notice the patient name displayed at the top of the screen. Hover the mouse over the name to see the full patient details. For the purposes of the training, we will run through a relaxed, forced, and post-bronchodilator test. Click the relaxed spirometry button. Attach a cardboard mouthpiece to the spirometer. If performing only expiratory tests, we recommend using a one-way mouthpiece. Power on the device by pressing the green power button. Details on fitting or replacing the batteries can be found in a separate video. A rapid flashing blue light will indicate the device is attempting to connect to the software. The light will go solid when connected, and the software will show connected in the bottom left corner. Also shown is the battery level. Click the Start button and wait for the blue light on the spirometer to go green. A beep will also be heard from the device, indicating it is ready for the test to be performed. Pass the Spiro Connect to the patient and begin the test maneuver. As the patient performs the blow, the live volume time curve will be displayed. At the end of the maneuver, the test summary screen will be shown. If the blow was not acceptable, click the Reject button. This will discard only the most recent blow. Previous blows will be retained. To accept the relaxed blow and perform a second, click the Next button. A minimum of 3 blows of acceptable quality should be performed. The acceptance criteria information only applies to forced blows and can be ignored when performing a relaxed maneuver. When sufficient blows have been performed, click the Done button. A confirmation message will appear. Click Yes to confirm that you have finished adding relaxed tests. Click No if you decide that you wish to perform more relaxed tests. Click the Add Base Forced button to begin the forced tests. The Spiro Connect will beep and the indicator light will go green. The flow volume graph will be displayed. If you prefer to view the test as a volume time curve, Click the tab to change the data presentation. The shaded area indicates the predicted range for the patient, based on age, gender, and ethnic origin. Begin the test. A forced blow should last at least 6 seconds. To assist the operator, the border of the flow volume curve will turn green when the patient achieves 6 seconds of blow. If the forced blow was of unacceptable quality, click the Reject button. This will only discard the most recent blow. Previous blows will be retained. To accept the blow and perform a second, click the Next button. A minimum of 3 blows of acceptable quality should be performed. The test summary displays the results after each blow, along with details of the quality of the maneuver and test variability. Test variability will be shown from the second blow onwards. The examination summary section shows the interpretation and whether or not the test acceptance criteria have been met based on the guidelines chosen by the user in the software settings. Examination notes can be added by clicking here and typing your notes in the box provided. Previous tests performed in the current examination can be reviewed by clicking on the specific test results. Also available is an incentive option, designed to encourage patients, particularly children, to keep blowing for as long as possible. A flashing smiley face on top of the building at the end of a maneuver indicates that a predefined incentive target set up in the Spiro Connect settings menu has been achieved by the patient. At the end of the blow, click the View Results button to see the test summary. When sufficient forced blows have been completed, click the Done button. If immediately performing post-bronchodilator forced tests, click the Add Post 1 Forced button and proceed with the post tests in the same way that the baseline tests were performed. If you are not performing any post-bronchodilator forced tests, or you are performing these after seeing another patient, you should click the Save and Exit button now to return to the home screen, then exit the software. A message will be displayed indicating the results are being exported to the i3 software. As the software closes, the spirometer switches off automatically, thus prolonging the battery life. The device will also switch off after a period of around 5 minutes of inactivity, but can be powered on again without loss of data by simply pressing the power button again. The i3 software will then present the data values available for filing to the patient record in the clinical system. We will look at the details of these shortly. If no post-bronchodilator values are detected in the data, there will be 2 filing options available. File results after post-tests are completed, or file. If post-bronchodilator tests will be completed within the next hour, click the File Results After Post-Tests Are Completed button. This will allow all values to be filed to the patient's medical record in the clinical system in a single entry after the post-bronchodilator tests are complete. If you are not performing post-bronchodilator tests or these have already been completed, click the File button to send the PDF report and read-coded data back to the clinical system. You will see the filing process later in the video. But for now, we will choose the file results after post-tests are completed option to simulate the patient leaving the room whilst the bronchodilator drugs take effect. Performing post-tests. When the patient returns to the room, load the patient record in the clinical system and click the i3 icon on your taskbar or desktop again. Verify the patient's details are correct by clicking Yes. The SpiroConnect software will start automatically. The software will display a message that recent tests have been detected. Click Yes to view this examination. If you want to record post-relaxed blows, click the Add Post 1 Relaxed button. Or, if preferred, you can skip these and move straight to the post-forced tests by clicking the Add Post 1 Forced button. As previously seen, if the blow was not acceptable, click the Reject button. Or to accept the blow, click the Next button. A minimum of 3 blows of acceptable quality should be performed. When sufficient blows have been completed, click the Done button. Save and exit the examination and exit the software. The i3 software will then present the data values available for filing to the patient record in the clinical system. Any items with data values available will automatically be selected for filing. Items can be deselected to prevent the data value from filing. Scroll down to see all the values and supplementary codes available for filing. Also available are some options to file read-coded entries relating to COPD and asthma monitoring. An oxygen saturation reading taken from an external device can be entered here and filed as a read-coded value alongside the spirometry data. The MRC breathlessness scale can be selected from the drop-down box and the read code will automatically be adjusted to reflect the grade selected. The PDF report can be previewed by clicking the View button. The PDF must be closed before the results will file. There is also space to enter an optional comment, which will be filed alongside the PDF attachment in the patient record. For example, you may want to put a note that this is the patient's annual review. When all the required options are chosen, check the clinical system hasn't timed out and locked. If so, unlock before proceeding. Click the File button to send the report and read-coded data back to the patient's medical record in the clinical system. The data may take a few seconds to file, depending on the number of values being transferred and the speed of the connection. A confirmation message will be shown when the data has filed successfully. The results can now be viewed in the patient record. If a consultation was open, you may need to refresh the data by clicking on the information bar. The data values will be shown in the consultation. and can also be seen in the Investigations tab. Double-clicking the attachment paperclip in Consultations view will open the PDF report of the spirometry test. Exporting historic results. Normally, results will be exported and filed to the patient record at the time the tests are performed. It is also possible to export and file historic results to the clinical system. Load the patient record in the clinical system and click the i3 icon on your taskbar or desktop. Click the Start button, then click the Spirometry icon. i3 will now connect to the clinical system and pull through the active patient's details. Ensure all details are correct, updating as necessary. Then click the Yes button to proceed. The SpiroConnect software will start with the patient's details loaded. Click the Review Examinations button. A list of examinations for the patient selected will be shown. Click on the examination to be exported and filed, then click the Choose Selected button. The spirometry examination will be displayed and can be reviewed on screen. To export and file the examinations to the clinical system, click the Mark for i3 Export button. This will return the software to the home screen. Exit the SpiroConnect software. A warning will be displayed that the results are historic, showing the date and time the examination was performed. Confirm these are the results you would like to file by clicking Yes. The examination readings will be available in the i3 filing screen. The results are filed in the same way as shown earlier in the training video. When filing historic results, the date and time of the examination will be shown as a comment alongside the filed report. Selecting the read-coded values for filing. The i3 software offers a wide range of data values for filing to the clinical system. You will not necessarily want to file all the values available. If there are read codes that you know you will never want to file, you can disable them and prevent them from appearing on the filing screen. Start the i3 software and click on the Settings icon. And then the Manage Read Codes button. Click the Spirometry Module tab. A list of all the available read codes will be shown. You can disable the filing of specific read codes by deselecting them here. If a data value has no corresponding read code shown, the read code is not available on that clinical system. It is possible to change the read code against which a particular parameter is filed. Please contact our technical support team for assistance in amending read codes. Be sure to click the Save button before exiting the screen to save your changes. You can also choose the default setting for the filing of the patient height and patient weight data. When Never is selected, the height and weight values will never be selected for filing by default. Selecting Always will select the height and weight values for filing, regardless of whether or not they were updated. Selecting When Updated will only select the values if you updated them at the time of beginning the test. Whatever option you choose, this can be overridden at the time of filing. Again, be sure to save any changes. More information about the integration software can be found in the user manual, which is accessible from the button on the welcome screen. This concludes the training on the product use. Separate videos are available covering subjects such as calibration verification, cleaning, and battery fitting and removal. If you need any more information on how to use the SpiroConnect system or integration software, please contact our technical support team on 0114 399 0010 or visit newmed.co.uk.